I am your host, James Yoder, of the Michigan Football Report. Michigan will play Alabama January 1st down in Orlando in the Citrus Bowl. But before we talk about that, we're going to go into some more around the bowl game, take your questions later in the show, some Michigan football news items, rumors, news, whatever you want to call it, to go through for you here on the show. Let's take a look at this one, because the chatter hasn't stopped. Not coming from anyone I trust. There's a lot of message board. I'm seeing it every single day on Twitter, getting people asking me about it all the time, really, since the Ohio State game. About a week straight, could Shea Patterson return? And you got to be thinking what I'm thinking. No, he can't return. And I even made fun of him for somebody who asked it on the show a couple weeks. I kind of joked with him and said, well, no, you really can't because, you know, he's a senior and he didn't redshirt. But there's a lot of chatter that Shea potentially could return for a fifth year. And how could that be possible? Well, here's the scenario where it could be possible. Let's say the NCAA comes to their senses, because I'm not sure why they didn't do this in the first place, and said, you know, in 2018, we implemented this redshirt rule where if you can play four games and still get up to four games and still redshirt, but there were guys who had been on campus for up to 3 years at that point that didn't get to benefit from that. So could somebody like Shea Patterson, who really is the godfather of the transfer portal, if you think about it, could Shea Patterson go to his lawyer, Thomas Mars, funny enough, I believe is now working for the NCAA, which is a kind of a nice twist of fate there. But could Shea Patterson, his family, through the Michigan Athletic Department or not, go and say, hey, how is this fair that he was a student athlete just like the guys who got to redshirt last year, just like the guys who got to redshirt in 2019 this season? Why shouldn't I get to go back and redshirt in 2016? I only played in three games. And oh, by the way, I was planning to redshirt the whole year. It was my starting quarterback, Chad, a.k.a. Swag Kelly, got hurt with three games left in the season. They forced a true freshman, Shea Patterson, in the game. So I think it'd be a valid case, and it's one of these things that the NCAA is going to take, if someone actually brought this to the forefront, like kind of like what we're doing now, could the NCAA just say, you know what, we don't even want to fight it. Just take your redshirts, kids. Anybody who played in 2016, less than four games or less, you guys can come back in 2020 if you want to as fifth-year seniors. Could happen, could not happen. I am not sure, but it's intriguing to think about. But I want to know from you guys, do you care or do you want Shea Patterson back in the 2020 season? Do you want Shea Patterson back next year? Not saying he's coming back. Let's just start that right there. I don't want any of this, Yoder saying Shea Patterson's coming back. I'm asking the question that it's out there. I have no idea at this point. But would you want him back? Because I've seen a lot of people, when I think it's crazy, saying no, I wouldn't even want Shea Patterson. I'd rather have the unknown. And you know what? I heard a lot of people say that about Will and Spate after 2016. And that John O'Corn, you see him throwing lasers down the field, but type two if yes, you want Shea back. That's his number two. Type 10, what's the 10 for? Dylan McCaffrey's number. We're trying to want everything to be a yes or a no, Y or N. So type two if you want Shea back next year. Type 10 if you would not want him back as Michigan's quarterback. I'm typing two because I sure as hell want 5,200 yards passing and, you know, almost 50 touchdowns and 12 interceptions over the unknown of Dylan, I get hurt every other play, McCaffrey, and Joe Milton, who we've not seen anything other than a couple throws out through the entire year. So type two for yes, type 10 for no. BetDSI is our presenting sponsor today. Get going betting on college football bowl season. We're probably like, what is it, 10 days away? When's the first game, Tom? Any idea? 12 days from now is the full bowl game, so the 20th. So you guys have 12 days to get that promo code GOBLUE, 120% deposit bonus. Get going now. Put some money on your hometown Pistons. Put some cash on Monday Night Football. Wherever you want to put money on sports, but make sure you do it with the best deposit bonus in the game. 120% deposit bonus. Chatsports.com/bet. Use that promo code GOBLUE. Don't miss out on the deposit bonus. Some sad news breaking as we went live here this afternoon. Former Michigan football head coach, former Michigan football All-American, Big Ten MVP, Bump Elliott, the coach who kind of turned over Michigan's best 20-year stretch over to Bo Schembechler. Was the coach in 1959 to 68, an All-American in 1947, Big Ten MVP. Was the coach the 10 years prior to Bo Schembechler taking over. Then he went on, actually, in 1970, ended Bo's second season and became athletic director at Iowa for 21 seasons. He's not only a College Football Hall of Famer as a player, he also went into the College Football Athletic Director Hall of Fame as well. So name that, unless you were born in the 2000s, I'm sure you've heard the name Bump Elliott as a Michigan football fan throughout the year. Legendary player, average coach, to be frank, but he was going, it's kind of like Brady Hoke or something, like going up against Urban Meyer. He was kind of outmatched going up against Woody Hayes for his entire 10 years as Michigan's head coach. Kind of one of the worst stretches as a Michigan football program, the 50s and early 60s were, but nevertheless, Bump Elliott, rest in peace. He has passed away at the age of 94. Now, let's take a look at five impact freshmen. Getting a lot of questions from you guys with signing day being, was it 10 days away from us now? Who could make an impact next season? So I took a look at the freshmen coming in for 2020, took a look at what I think is going to be the opportunities for playing time, and then matched talent to coaching staff to opportunity. And these are our five impact freshmen for 2020. These are the guys I think are going to see the field, will get plenty of playing time, and will be names that you will know by middle of the year next year. Let's start off first with Blake Corum, four-star running back, the player of the year out of the state of Maryland. He is a dynamic running back. He is unlike what Michigan has right now. They've got two more bruisers in Hassan Haskins, Zach Charbonnet. Blake Corum is a lightning-fast running back. Go check out his tape out there. It is awesome. I think he will definitely be in the three-deep running back rotation from game one next year. With wide receiver departures, potentially, and with how much Michigan used freshman wide receivers this year, certainly Mike Sainristol, certainly Giles Jackson, and then we saw Cornelius Johnson get in the field the last four or five games of the year. I think A.J. Henning, you know, he'll get on the field for sure. The Gatorade Player of the Year from the state of Illinois, Michigan's highest rated recruit as of now, depending on what service you use, but I believe it's still the highest in the 24/7 composite. He reminds me a lot of that Giles Jackson or the, I guess just Giles Jackson, Mike Sainristol type. He's smaller, he's quicker, he is not a DPJ or Nico Collins, 6'2", 6'4", guy that's going to go up deep down the field. He's going to be more of a speed and space guy that Josh Gass is going to be using as we go on with this new emerging Michigan football spread offense that was pretty good the last three or four games of the year, but struggled early on. How about RJ Moten, four-star safety, and Makari Paige? Both these guys dropped a little bit in rankings throughout their senior year. Not sure if that's because they got worse at their game or other players got better from the safety position in particular. But Michigan's bringing in two top 200, 250 players at the safety position, where you are losing longtime starter at that position and have had injury issues. Brad Hawkins missed the last couple games of the year. Dax Hill, I believe, will move there, but potentially could he move to cornerback position as we go on. So not much depth in the secondary next year, and certainly not much proven depth in the secondary overall going into 2020. So I think RJ Moten, Makari Paige will see time there. And then Andre Seldon, saw an awesome video of him going head-to-head against the number one wide receiver in the country who's committed to Ohio State and really took it to him. So I think he will get into the two deep, top four or five cornerbacks, maybe nickel potentially next year. And so those five players, I believe, will get playing time for the Wolverines in 2020. Predict the score, guys. We're going to have your questions coming up. Go through some stuff going on in the YouTube and the Facebook comments. But predict the score. Michigan-Alabama in the Citrus Bowl, January 1st. This isn't a New Year's Six game. It certainly isn't a college football playoff game. But nevertheless, I think it'll probably be the one that the average Joe football fan will be most interested in watching just because of the programs and the interest level that the two head coaches, Jim Harbaugh and Nick Saban, bring. So predict the score below. I'll give you my prediction as we get closer to game time. We've got the deal of the day. If you're still out there looking for Christmas gifts, you got 17 days till Christmas. You better jump on it. You're not going to find a better deal than this. The Michigan football Block M shirt, 60% off. Now it's only $12. Dylan, you better believe it. How about this one? The Michigan football jacket, half off, 50%, $32.50. Chatsports.com/blue1. All these links we're going to put for you in the live chat here in a moment. If anybody can get that in the live chat, I'd certainly appreciate it. The stats and research team, I got it actually. No big deal. We're going to put this in the Facebook, the YouTube live chat. All Michigan football sale items, chatsports.com/blue. We'll put it in the live chat. Afterwards, I'll put it on Twitter. You can go down in the comments after the show is done being live or the description to get these items. Don't miss out on sale items, chatsports.com/blue.